anybody here tonight, there is a personality that follows you. Some people see it physically, others it is in the night. Are there personalities that have showed up in the dream to warn you and to challenge your existence? Any person or personality masquerading himself or herself in the spirit realm, coming to warn you in the dream or following you about to distract your destiny, or attacking you in seen or unseen ways, or attacking your destiny in known or unknown ways, have come tonight for us to declare your time is up in the name of our Lord Jesus. Your time is up in the name of our Lord Jesus. You are made in the image, you are made in the glory of God. Therefore, another personality cannot masquerade to come and challenge the glory and the image of God that you are created in. I declare tonight, anyone that is here and there are powers that are challenging the glory of God in your life, tonight, that power, their time is up in the name of our Lord Jesus. Are there powers? Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. There's already deliverance all over tonight. Because I heard the Lord say, as soon as I come here, I should announce to these powers, to these personalities, that their time of harassing the saints is up in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Tonight you are here to say to that Pharaoh, to that Herod, to that spirit of Jezebel, to Atalia spirit, to the spirit of wickedness, to the ancestral spirit, to the witchcraft spirit, whatever is that spirit that has been following you, harassing you, warning you in the dream, following you physically or spiritually, we stand again in the name of our Lord Jesus to declare your time is up in the name of our Lord Jesus. Psalm 18 verse 45. Psalm 18 verse 45. The Bible says that foreigners shall fade away and come frightened from their hideouts. And so tonight we are addressing foreigners. Whatever has been monitoring you, following you, harassing your life is what? A foreigner. And the Bible said that this foreigner shall do what? They shall do what? They shall do what? And number two, they shall come what? Frightened from their hide out. That is what will happen now. In the name of our Lord Jesus. Verse 46. Let's start from verse 44. Let's start from verse 44. Psalm 18 from verse 44, it says, as soon as they hear of me, they shall do what? Obey me. I declare tonight, whatever and whatsoever represents strangers, monitoring powers, and foreigners that are following you, the Bible said, as soon as they hear of me, they must obey me. I declare tonight, every power representing foreigners harassing your destiny and their ancestral powers, they must obey you in the name of our Lord Jesus. As we pray tonight, every follow spirit must obey you in the name of our Lord Jesus. Every monitoring spirit, they must obey you in the name of our Lord Jesus. Every demonic power or stronghold assigned against manipulate your destiny, to oppress you, and to manipulate your life and destiny. I declare in the name of our Lord Jesus, they must obey you. In the name of our Lord Jesus, declare the powers that I was afraid of. Tonight I now am no better. You shall obey me. Declare it. Tonight, whatever I'm afraid of, you're a foreigner, and you must begin to do what? Obey me. You know, there's a reason why we are not comfortable with something that is foreign. It is normal to be uncomfortable with what is foreign. But what will become the new normal for you is that you should not be afraid of them, but you should know that you are in a position to command them so they shall obey you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus tonight. I set the hedge of the fire of the Holy Ghost in this atmosphere. I secure our loved ones, everything that is important to us, as we begin to veer into warfare tonight. I release the angels of God to watch. Tonight is your night of recovery. It's a night of deliverance. It's a night of liberation. It's a night of freedom in the name of our Lord Jesus. It marks an end of a season of oppression and open doors and gates to a season of it's a shift. It's a night that is shifting you to the place you have always desired to be in. It's a night to take you to a place where you become comfortable with your spiritual life. In the name of our Lord Jesus. I said the reason why we were afraid or not comfortable with what is foreign, like when you see a lump growing in a part of your body. Nobody wants to see a lump in the breast. It's foreign. But when you have this revelation that the lump should hear me and obey me, and that foreigner should submit to me, it means that whether it is a physical or a spiritual or seen and unseen foreigner, in every realm of my life I'm uncomfortable with, they must submit to me. Verse 45. They must do what? Submit to me. Because the first thing is that something has to hear you. Something has to do what? Hear you and obey you before they can do what? Submit. And so tonight, deliverances you've been battling with, because the powers have refused to hear. Under the cloud of glory, it's already started, because the cloud is already here. Those powers you have struggled with, you know, there was a prayer I know God gave me victory before I came here. I told God, everyone you have appointed to be here will be here. And when they come, open them up. Give everyone wisdom, revelation and understanding. That while the teaching is going on, even if they are young Christians, let them have revelation of what is said, so they can be able to receive the full weight of your glory tonight. And I'm sure when I speak, it's coming clear. Even if your head was full, you were worried before you came here, there's a lifting already that has been accomplished before you arrived. So when I open up the scripture, please follow the scripture. Psalm 18 verse 44, let's look at it again. It says, Psalm 18 verse 44 says, as soon as you hear of me, they obey me and they submit. I tell you sincerely today, even your loved ones, those that you ought to mentor who don't obey, children that are now like foreigners, sometimes you'll be wondering, did I give birth to this child? There's a spirit disturbing that child. We will be here praying, whether it's your loved one, brother or sister, who is disturbed by some kind of foreign, strange spirit that have taken hold of their life and their destiny. As soon as they hear of me, so you need to call their names. The foreigners controlling their life will submit to you. verse 45. The powers disturbing your business, as soon as they hear of you today, they shall submit to you. And what are they submitting to you for? The foreigners shall fade away. They submit to do what? Fade away. They submit to do what? Fade away. So as soon as they submit, they will fade away. This is how long-standing problems will fade away. In the name of our Lord Jesus. This is how complex problems will do what? Fade away. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And the Bible said, and they will come frightened from their hide out. They will come doing what? They'll be coming out, you know, tonight while their glory keeps building up. Powers will be coming out. The Bible said they will come frightened. Why are they frightened? Because they know they're in trouble. Tonight, the enemy of your soul is in trouble in Jesus' name. The enemy of your destiny is in trouble in Jesus' name. The enemy of your career is in trouble in Jesus' name. The powers that trouble you and trouble your loved ones, they are in trouble in Jesus' name. Those that have troubled you today, they too, today is their day of trouble. We have a common saying that says that every day is for the thief, but one day is for the owner of the house. Today is your own day of vengeance. They have been coming in the secret, coming from their hideout. It says, and they shall come frightened from their what? Hideout. So it means that all these spirits have a hideout, yes. They can hide out in your eyes, hide out in your stomach, hide out in any part of your body, hide out in your house, hide out in your children, hide out in your business, hide out in your money. So long as the Bible tells us right now that they have what? A hide what? Out. From their hideout, they are already frightened in their hideout. You know, like, why do people put fire in the bush? So that the rats will come out from their what? Hideout. The rodents are coming out from their what? Because tonight there's a different kind of flame. The fire of tonight is the fire of the glory of God. It's called white fire. Fire has grade. There is yellow light, red light, blue light. But when the glory of God comes, it's a white light. It does not smoke. It don't struggle. You don't negotiate. Tonight is a night of his glory. And the dazzling presence of his beauty and power does not allow any darkness anywhere in Jesus' name. And if you open up yourself tonight for God to release his glory into your life, surely, I have no doubt about it. Why are they in hideout? Let me tell you why they go into hideout. These powers go into hideout so that when you dream, you forget your dream. You dream, you don't even remember your dream. They hide. They be troubling you and tormenting you from their what? They will throw something at you, you cannot. They'll be talking, following you. There are people who are hearing voices here, but they're hiding, you can't see them. The day they will appear is when you are weak, they will warn you. That's why I said, any power following you, their time is up in the name of our Lord Jesus. They hide out wherever they are. Are they in the grave in your father's compound? Are they operating as ancestral powers? Are they spirits that are in caves, in mountains, in hills, or in the wilderness? Wherever they're hiding, in the ocean, the river, the waters, in the moon, the sun, and the star, and then launch their attack from there. Today, in the name of our Lord Jesus, we declare that their time is up in the name of our Lord Jesus. For the Bible said they are foreigners, and it is time for them to fade away. way, and they shall come frightened from their hideouts. After tonight, your dreams you will remember. Your dream is your spiritual thermometer. God uses it to show you things. So you can know your enemy. They know that if you see your dream and you can remember, then you can pray. Then you can break it. Then you can send back the arrow. But when you no longer remember your dream, but eat in the dream, have sex in the dream, continue being so involved in activities you cannot explain. Even the one you are dreaming, you wake up, you can't remember what you are dreaming immediately. That is somebody that is in a deep slumber. And foreigners have captured that mind. Are there evil plantations? Evil plantations by this evil demonic personality. All they do is to come in the spirit to project something through their words. But they are coming out now in the name of our Lord Jesus. The Bible says that the strangers must obey you tonight, as it is written. As soon as they hear of me, the foreigners shall submit. Is anyone here that has been taken to an evil altar? While you are here, your picture is somewhere thousands of miles. And somebody is calling your name. A foreigner is using your image somewhere to control your person that is here. Tonight, that foreigner, their time is up. In the name of our Lord Jesus, that altar, their time is up. In the name of our Lord Jesus, we decree and declare. The Bible says the foreigners shall fade away. They shall come out frightened from their hideouts. In the name of our Lord Jesus, I therefore decree and declare there shall be sudden exposures, sudden revelations. In the name of our Lord Jesus, of unfriendly friends, people you gave your clothes to, your shoes to, your properties to, and they have carried it to an altar with an evil mind and intention to exchange your destiny, to exchange your blessing. That person is not a friend. That person is a foreigner. And they're fading away from your friendship today. In the name of our Lord Jesus. They're fading away from your business. In the name of our Lord Jesus. They're fading away from relationship. They're fading away from interaction. They're fading away from that deception. In the name of our Lord Jesus. Shall cause them to wither. I command the powers standing behind that altar, wither in the name of our Lord Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus over whatever that belongs to you that have been taken to that wicked altar. And I declare, whatever it is they have done with you, your picture or a point of contact that have caused you to suffer losses, today we revert it and revoke it in the name of our Lord Jesus. We declare your restoration in the name of our Lord Jesus. We declare your restoration. I release the fire of the Holy Ghost in the water, and I declare any agent of darkness today that is here, I command in the name of our Lord Jesus, let the fire and the brimstone of God gather you together like a whirlwind and throw you into where you came from. In the name of Jesus, right now be gone. By fire, nobody's blessing or glory shall be stolen today in the name of our Lord Jesus. I address all star hijackers. You must vomit it. You must vomit it. You must vomit it. You must release people's stars. People people's blessings, people's glory right now in the name of our Lord Jesus. It's already a mystery. People are coming out. Coming out. Those that they buried are coming out. Coming out from the grave. They buried you in the grave. Come out. Come out. Come out. Come out. Come out. Come out. Tonight is the night of exchange. They buried you. No way. Okay, good, they made a grave. Everyone that a grave has been made for. Like the gallows that was made for Haman, by Haman for Mordecai. I declare that exchange will take place tonight. Like the night that Haman took the gallows. Tonight, anyone that have made a grave for you, let that man have the exchange. Take that grave in the name of our Lord Jesus. Arrow fashioned for you, I command it in Jesus' name. Back to sender in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Whatever says that you shall not enjoy the glory of God tonight. Whatever powers that is standing to hinder your spiritual life and growth, that will not allow you to function as God has ordained and for you to fulfill destiny. Tonight is a night of your destiny recovery. I therefore command in the name of our Lord Jesus, strangers, you must obey. And I command every stranger assigned against your destiny must submit to you right now in the name of our Lord Jesus. This is your time. Begin to make declarations. Command them to fade away. Command them to come out of their hideout. In the name of our Lord Jesus, begin to pray. Call the name of your loved one. Command in the name of our Lord Jesus. Powers that is oppressing their life, powers oppressing their destiny, command them that they must obey you. Command them that they must submit to you. As they obey and submit to you, bind their powers in Jesus' name. Loose your loved one from the diabolical powers. Stop the flow of the wicked anointing. Command that the foreigners must fade away from their life and they must come out from their hiding places. The power of God is all over. Tonight is a night of great glory. It's a night of an exchange that is an unremarkable. It's a night that is unforgettable. It's a night that is remarkable and unremarkable for the wicked. Tonight they will regret it. Tonight. In the name of our Lord Jesus. This brother that is in a striped shirt. See him here. Yes. Touch him. Madabo Jagade Bayana Hagade. I declare in the name of our Lord Jesus, anyone that is using your glory, are there people that are trading with your glory? I'm using him as a point of contact in the name of Jesus, wherever you are here now. Is there anybody that is here tonight and somebody is trading with your glory? Somebody is living big with your glory. Someone has exchanged your glory. I command in the name of our Lord Jesus, let that glory be restored back to you now in the name of our Lord Jesus. I command in the name of Jesus, restoration of lost glory by the count of five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Anyone that is here that your glory was exchanged, I command whoever is using that glory, restore it back to you now in the name of Jesus. Did they shave your hair in the dream? Did they shave your hair while you were sleeping? Did they shave your hair like Samson in the hands of Delilah? Did you put yourself in an unforgettable, merciless relationship and your glory was stolen? It's also a night of mercy. It's a night that your glory will grow back. Whatever is behind an uncontrollable passion, uncontrollable emotion, you will not fall, then you fall again. You say it, you fall again. Wherever your glory is hidden, we command the hideout where they hid your glory. As the foreigners come out from the hideout, they are going to come out with the glory. In the name of our Lord Jesus. And so I declare tonight in Jesus' name. Is there any of you that has been taken to any marketplace? They have taken your destiny to go and thread in the market of darkness, in kingdom of darkness. We take the token of the blood of Jesus to whichever market your destiny has been traded, to repurchase you by the token of the blood in Jesus' name. Some of us can't get a job because it's been traded already in the market, in the evil market. As this word comes to you, whatsoever it is that you can find him, we find you in the name of our Lord Jesus. My prayer for you today is that all that buried your glory, today shall be the day that the buried glory shall resurrect again in Jesus' name. All attempt to turn your glory to shame by the powers of darkness, I stand here to declare in the name of our Lord Jesus, it has failed in Jesus' name. He is here to recreate the glory of men. In the cloud of his glory, in the cloud of the glory of God, is the creative power. It was in that creative power, in the glory that hovered over the face of the earth, that God created the greater sun and the greater light and the lesser light, and called the greater one sun and gave it his own glory, and then did the lesser light and then gave it his own glory. There is one glory of the sun, another glory of the moon, and another glory of the star. For one star differs from another in glory. You have your own glory. You are unique. You have your own glory. You are unique. You have your own glory. You are unique. Each and every one of you, you differ. You have your own glory. I got my own glory. Every single one of us have their own what? That's what the scripture is saying. There's one glory of the sun and another glory of the God created that whole glory. You don't have to compete with another person. You don't have to compare yourself with another. God's glory in his life does not stop your own glory. That she's shining does not stop you from shining. Why not discover what to shine and how to shine and start shining than struggling to put out another person's glory? Why you are trying to pull down another and stop that person's shine? You are destroying your own glory. Are you there with me? Are you there with me? Tonight is the night of glory. One of the things I shared this week, I said, we must stop what? Complaining. Stop what? Murmuring. Stop what? Grumbling. It takes away glory from men. When God is about to bless you, there are certain people that have a degree in making you angry. So that when that anger comes, that blessing that will come, they lift it. I decree and declare in the name of our Lord Jesus this hour, whatever is competing with your glory, whatever powers that are assigned to decrease your glory or to replace it or to demote it, I decree in the name of our Lord Jesus, your time is up. In the name of our Lord Jesus, I declare your time is what? Up. cry out, say, Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus, any demon attached to my life, in Jesus' name, your time is up. I command you, in the name of Jesus, now depart, now depart, now pray that prayer. Command that demon to go one way to the pit, in the name of our Lord Jesus. Demons tormenting you, tormenting your loved ones, in the name of our Lord Jesus, you can stand in the gap for your loved one or your family. Command that demon to go one way to the pit. They have no legal grounds. The mercy has been released. Everyone here has had a chance to be saved. There is no sin in our midst. No power has any right to remain. Therefore, in the name of our Lord Jesus, we stand at the righteousness of Christ. All of us are standing as the redeemed of the Lord. We stand as freed men. And because his mercy speaks, we therefore decree and declare, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus, we are new creatures. All things have passed away. Therefore, you demon, you have to go. Speak to that demon that is coming from anywhere, whether ancestral. It's broken. The ancestral link, the curse is broken. Now pray, now pray, now pray, now pray, now pray. Take this prayer up. Take it up, take it up. Take it up, take it up, take it up. We are the gate of the midnight hour. Take it up. Tonight, we are separating you from that demon that has been harassing your family, harassing your children, harassing you. Tonight, in the name of our Lord Jesus, so long as God reigns and you submit to him, foreigners, all of them, they must depart. They must be away. They must fade away. In the name of our Lord Jesus, are they in the cave? They must come out. It's time to depart. There's no hiding place again for the wicked. We command in Jesus' name, let them be frightened away. Foreigners, fade away. Come out from your hiders. Come out from your hiders. Come out from your hiders. Every demon hiding in their eyes, hiding anywhere in your body, command them, come out. Come out. Come out. Come out. Let all the curses issued against you now be converted to blessings. Let them be converted to blessings. Are they curses that are issued? Whatever part of your life they have been issued, we are converting them to blessing. They are coming out in the name of our Lord Jesus. They are coming out in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus. We command every curse of mental or physical sickness, we command it now to be converted to blessing. No one is allowed again to suffer mental or physical sickness. We convert all that causes connected with mental harassment. We command it now. We convert it to blessings. In the name of our Lord Jesus, we convert it to blessings. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. We convert right now failure and defeat. Failure and defeat. Demons attached to it, we command them go one way to pit. We convert it to blessings in Jesus' name. We declare now, those that are connected to family breakup, they cause marriages to break up. We declare today in Jesus' name, those demons, causes connected with family breakup, marriage breakup, we convert it to blessing in Jesus' name. Demons that are connected to oppression, powers that bring oppression in the lives of your people, Lord, we convert it to blessing in Jesus' name. Powers connected with personal destruction, we declare nobody shall commit suicide again. Powers that push you to think of suicide, powers that push you to destroy yourself, we convert them to blessings in Jesus' name. We convert them to blessings in Jesus' name. We declare no more thought of self-destruction. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus, you shall not face shame. In the name of our Lord Jesus, that thought of barrenness, that thought of suicide, that fear of arthritis, or manners of sickness that are connected through these causes, we command it now in the name of our Lord Jesus. They are converted to blessings. Converted to blessings in the name of our Lord Jesus. Converted to blessings in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus. Converted to blessings in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus. I declare your heart will no longer be polluted again. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus, your heart again will no longer be polluted. your heart will no longer see sorrow. In the name of our Lord Jesus, your heart will no longer be filled with strange thoughts and desires. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I decree and declare today, according to the words and the promises of God to us, strangers, foreigners shall fade away. Pray with me, say, every wicked devourer against my destiny, expire, 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 in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in Psalm 145 verse 20, the Lord preserveth all that love him, but the wicked shall be destroyed. Therefore, I am preserved of the Lord in Jesus' name. Pray with me, say, do you have this in the media? Do you have this in projection, this prayer? Is it there? Yes or no? If you have it, yes, can you bring it up? Are you ready to pray some more? You still feel like praying? Raise up your hand, let me see you. So let's pray. We're going to pray. They're going to bring it up. We'll pray. I don't know why God chose tonight to go this way. Maybe, you know, I found out that this COVID left many people with issues. Some of them are hidden fears. You don't know they are there. Sometimes you don't know it, but you just feel it. And I just feel we need to deal with it very well and comb it out, you know, clean out very well. Let's pray. Then we'll get into worship. Are you ready? Can you bring up the prayers? Bring up the prayers. It's long and plenty. As a matter of fact, we have 50 prayer points, 50 scriptures. I've not even started the prayers for tonight. This is the prayers for tonight. All I'm doing is revelations. I've just been doing my revelation, but these are the prayers that we are thoughtfully prepared for tonight. So if we don't come through with it, we are still in the 40 days, we'll still go through it. I feel a very awesome power and presence of God here. If you have it, do you have the prayer points itself with the scriptures? If you can you bring out the prayer points? If I like the way it is, if we can go fast, we go fast. We have 2 minutes to go to 12 midnight. I want to believe God that nobody's life or destiny again should be harassed and afflicted by personality following you and showing up to warn you, whether physically or spiritually. Your time is what? Up. That harassment is over. In the name of our Lord Jesus. You say it's what? Over in Jesus' name. Pray with me. Say, every wicked devourer against my destiny, expire in the name of Jesus. Can you say this prayer? Say this prayer. Something will happen by 12 midnight. Say, my real me, hear the cry from heaven, manifest in Jesus' name. You know, the Bible said, my real me, say my real me. Some of us are not your real self, eh? In a minute time, you will manifest now. Somebody cry and say, my real me. Hear the cry from heaven. Manifest now in Jesus' name. Pray that prayer. My real me, not the one that is stolen, not my destiny that is hijacked. Manifest, 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 manifest. My glory manifest. My real me, hear the cry from heaven. Manifest now in Jesus' name. Pray that prayer. Manifest, 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 manifest. Yeah, I read you. You know yourself. You know who you are supposed to be. Manifest now. Manifest now. Manifest now. Manifest now. Manifest now. Manifest now. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Manifest now in Jesus' name. Manifest now. There are some of you that should have married, but the face you are carrying is not your face. Somebody have changed your face. That's your face that God gave to you, that image of glory. I command it. That face of beauty, I command it in the name of our Lord Jesus. Manifest now. Manifest now in the name of our Lord Jesus. Amen. Okay, somebody that has an arrow that has been in your chest for a long time. You've been carrying that affliction. That affliction is over. I command that arrow from your heart. They call it heart pain, but it's ending now. In the name of our Lord Jesus, that pain that entered your heart, that arrow, any arrow that entered any part of your life, I command it come out one way, back to sender in Jesus' name. And I decree your liberty right now in the name of our Lord Jesus. Now recover, now recover, now recover, now recover. Recover in the name of our Lord Jesus. Recover yourself in Jesus' name. You know, this prayer point can become PowerPoint media. If it's PowerPoint, they can see it. The way it is, it's difficult for them to see it. So be working on it. Now say, coven powers from my place of birth, your time is up. Expire by fire in the name of Jesus. You evil bird, carry message against me and my family. Crash land in Jesus' name. Crash land in Jesus' name. Are you afraid of saying these prayers? Are you afraid of saying these prayers? You cannot be afraid. Say these prayers and get your results immediately. Declare in Jesus' name, coven powers from my place of birth, your time is up. Expire in the name of Jesus. Expire in the name of Jesus. Expire, 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 expire in the name of Jesus. Pray with me, say, you evil bird, carry message against me and my family. Crash land in the name of Jesus. Pray that prayer now. Command it to crash land in the name of our Lord Jesus. Command it. Let it crash land in Jesus' name. Pray with me. Say, powers confronting my destiny, I stone you to death. I stone you to death in the name of our Lord Jesus. Pray with me. Say, every Goliath troubling my destiny, fall and die and perish in Jesus' name. My life, hear the word of the Lord, go forward in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus. Every cloud assigned to bring wicked rain upon my life and my family, scatter in the name of our Lord Jesus. Amen. And I say, every load of the enemy in my life, go back to the sender in the name of Jesus. Any evil hand pointed at my destiny, wither and paralyze in Jesus. Arrows of shame targeted against me and my family, backfire in Jesus' name. You have Job chapter 5 verse 12 and Romans 9:13. Every power holding my instrument of advancement, release them now in Jesus' name. I'm going to pray this one because I want an instant answer. Proverbs chapter 3 verse 27. Proverbs chapter 3 verse 27. Somebody get ready. There are people who must tonight under this glory receive now instrument of their advancement. See, the Bible says, do not withhold good from those to whom it is due when it is in their power or your hand to do so. There are people that it is in their hand and are holding the good. Pray with me, say, every power holding my instrument of advancement, release them to me now in the name of our Lord Jesus. Now pray it. Pray it now. Pray it. As you are praying it, any hand at this midnight hour, seen or unseen hands, holding your instrument of advancement, I command it right now to release it unto you now in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name. Every power planning my demotion, go down in Jesus' name. 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 You know why? Deuteronomy 28 verse 13 says, I've made you the head and not the tail. So nobody can make you the tail. Pray with me. Say, Jesus' name. I declare in Jesus' name, every power planning my demotion, go down in Jesus' name. You know, when you are saying go down, you should see yourself becoming the head. And you should see the power going down. Every power planning my demotion, I command you, go down in Jesus' name. 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 As we are saying that prayer, it's your rising. It's your rising. God said, you shall be the head and not the tail. Say, oh God of Elijah, arise. Let my story change in the name of our Lord Jesus. Every arrow fired into my star, come out and return back to your senders in Jesus' name. Powers that hate to see me laugh, expire in Jesus' name. Every star assassin against me, I command you to collapse in Jesus' name. Star swallowers of my father's house, vomit my star in the name of Jesus. You diviners attacking my star, run mad in Jesus' name. Run mad in Jesus' name. Run mad in Jesus' name. Isaiah 44:25 says, that frustrate the token of liars and making diviners to run mad. Pray with me. Say, every evil man pursuing my star, perish in Jesus' name. This was Herod that was asking about when the star was seen. That those that are waiting to see when you get pregnant. Powers of my father's house, assigned to bury my star, catch fire in Jesus' name. Every dark powers targeting my star, be permanently destroyed in the name of Jesus. Every power toiling with my destiny, your time is up. Expire in the name of Jesus. Every power attacking my dream, your time is up in the name of our Lord Jesus. The Bible says they shall come in one way and be scattered in seven ways. Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 7. One thing that must be restored tonight is your dream life. This is the time they come to feed you, mess you up. Say, every cloud, every dark cloud covering my dream life, in the cloud of this glory, I command you be lifted in the name of Jesus. From tonight, I shall receive my dream and I shall have my revelation and the meaning of the revelation and my destiny, I call it into place in the name of Jesus. Amen. Declare every witchcraft altar in my compound, in my house. Is it in Revival City? I command you, cut, 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 cut. In the name of Jesus. There's something I saw now I want to deal with. There are people that specialize in putting their coven, codron meeting at gates, at windows and at doors. I've never heard that prayer point before, but I'm hearing it now, that we are going to destroy whatever our mysteries that are hanging on any gate, door or window, in a way to hinder your doors from opening or windows or gates. We command in the name of Jesus, whatsoever that witchcraft altars have formed or fashioned and placed at my gate, at my window, at my door, to hinder or to stop my destiny. In the name of Jesus, I command you tonight, cut, 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 cut. In the name of Jesus. Tonight, I'm taking authority of our world, the walls of our house. We are not there. Are you sharing flats? Are you sharing flats with somebody? We are charging the roof of your house. We are charging the floor. If there's somebody living in the flat with you, we are charging your walls. If you are sharing compound or even the road and the street, by this time, whatever means they use to traveling, we are charging their transportation system that they carry to use to enter your house. We charge it by the blood of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, by the fire of the Holy Ghost, and declare their time is up. Your environment now is uncomfortable for powers to enter, to dwell, or to exist with you. Hear me, some people will relocate because this fire will continue. I tell you, within 7 days, this environment will remain too hot. Whether it's in your village, your loved ones, wherever they are, we command in Jesus' name, their roof, their floor, their walls, their gates, we command in the name of Jesus. Catch, 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 in the name of Jesus. I see some people in your compound acting as if they're running mad. Wherever any witch is sharing any space with you, any witch that is sharing any space with you, I command in the name of Jesus, cut, 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 cut. In the name of Jesus, tonight, anyone that dares to project out of their body, returning will be a problem. From now, hey, the environment will be too hot. Whatever has entered cannot go out. Whatever has gone out cannot come in. Everything now is mandated to reduce to ashes. As long as it's not from God and it's from the devil to harm you, it must do what? Cut! In the name of Jesus, cut! 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 In Jesus' name. I'm worried and upset. All this season of people sit at home, don't go to church. People have become so lazy with their spiritual life. A pastor told me, midweek service, you call, you don't see people. People's water are cold. Going to church, they drag. This is the plan of the devil. But tonight, your bed will catch fire. Your Bibles will catch fire. Your altar will catch fire. Your table will catch fire. Your hunger for God will catch fire. There will be a passion of God again. You know what the devil did is to make the things of God cold, that the people of God will be struggling with their spiritual life. Meanwhile, witches will be catching fire to fly. The fire they will catch today is the one that will consume them. The fire that you catch today is the one that will give you power and passion for God in Jesus' name.